So in this video, we will learn about how do we configure Farget service in ECS and why do we use it. So Farget is a technology in ECS which provides us a way where we do not have to be bothered about the ECS or EC2 instances. For example, if we have to scale up or scale down, we do not have to be bothered about scaling up and scaling down manually. We just have to be bothered about creating our task definition, and voila, we are done with our setup. So this is what Farget service provides. And how do we create it and how do we configure it? Let's see. So for creating and configuring it, let's create a cluster. When creating a cluster, we would be only using this option, as we would be only bothering about the networking. We would not be bothered about how to configure and how to scale up, scale down the EC2 instances. So you would choose this option, which is the first option, and then the cluster. The cluster name is ECS Farget Demo. And then I would not choose enable it and keep the things as default. I'll go to the cluster and I'll create a service. I'll choose Farget here, but it is telling me that you can't use this task definition because this task definition has not configured as Farget. So for using task definitions or configuring task definitions for Farget type service, we have to define task definitions for Farget only. So let's create a task definition for Farget. I'm choosing Farget option here. Let's go give a name. Let me choose Farget task definition. Task role, I'll go with the existing role I have. ECS task execution role. I'll go with the 1 GB memory. I'll go with the 0.25 for CPU utilization. I'll go with the container. Sorry. For container, let me copy my image URI from the ECR repo. I'll copy this. If you guys are clueless on how I have got this ECR image URI or task definition, then you guys have to watch my earlier videos. I have specified steps of how do we create ECR and how do we push our images to ECR and create task definition service. I'll keep everything as default here. I'll provide my port 80 for my container because in this image I'm using 80 as my container port, and I'll keep everything as default. I'll go to my task definition. I'm done with my task definition. The next step and the only step is to choose Farget here and choose this Farget task definition. I'll use the latest version, cluster, this cluster, and service Farget demo service. Number of tasks, 2 number of tasks. I'll keep everything the rolling update as default. If you guys see, it did not ask me about the deployment. There's one more option we usually see when we create a service for the normal non-Farget way. It didn't ask us about the deployment of tasks procedure, as in are we going to use Beanstalk or spread, what way. So because AWS is taking care of that way for us, we do not have to be bothered about that. So now on this page, I'm configuring the VPS I'll be using for this service. I'll be using the default one I have and all the subnets under that VPC. I'll have this auto assign public IP to my tasks or yes to my task or EC2 instances. I do not again have to bother about that. Let's not have this enabled. I have already explained about how do we configure it inside my other videos, which you can see in the playlist, and I'll keep it as do not adjust the service desired because I do not have the auto screen group enabled here. Create the service, and within 30 seconds I'll have the tasks running in my Fargate type cluster. And see, I didn't create any EC2 instance, I didn't do any configuration over there, I did not do any monitoring or configuration. All I have is I just have created task definition and my service, and I have two running tasks for me. I'll go to my specific task and I can see the public IP from here. I'll copy and show you guys how it is working. I didn't have to be bothered about what port I have to configure inside my security group for my EC2 instances. So here I can access my task. If I go to this task, see if it is working or not, public IP. And see, the public IP here is 232.131.243. And I'll go to the other instance, 2355584. The public IP is different. So I have AWS Fargate did this for me, created two instances, two tasks on different IP. I do not have to bother about that. So that's what Fargate is. It is pretty easy than the conventional normal way of creating EC2 instances and then managing them with cluster. So that is it.